The saddest sadistic love story. The scar on his arm looked like a flying bat, raised, jagged, red purple. It glistened between the silver hairs on Storm's arm whenever he rolled his sleeve up to saw a log in the yard. His rusty saw, his stare, and the scar stuck in my memory like a splinter. Storm, Ovenia Stomberg, lived all alone in a room at the end of the long hallway of our communal apartment in dusty Odessa. Everyone called him Storm, but no one really talked to him. He never drank vodka with men. He never slapped women on their jiggling behinds in the steam-drenched kitchen. During the day, his room stayed dark. At sunset, he limped out down the corridor, settled on the bench in the yard, and rolled cigarettes. A tall black cat usually sat by his side. For hours, they stared in the distance in silence. Then he saw logs. One evening, just before dusk, I stepped out into the yard. I saw Nikita, a boy from the other yard, hunched over something under the linden. I ran over. He held Storm's black cat in the canvas bag, the strings around its neck. Nikita pulled on the strings, his mouth twisted, the cat's eyes popped out like soap bubbles and covered with whitish film. Its red mouth opened. A pink tongue stuck out like a piece of plastic washed up on the seashore. A strange hissing sound came out of the cat's throat. I didn't think long. I took a rock from the ground and hit Nikita on his dirty blonde head, right above his temple. He let go of the bag and grabbed his head, bright blood splashing through his fingers, pouring over his bitten nails. I untied the strings and cat in hands, hot and heavy, ran back towards the door. Nikita stamped after me, raising dust in the air, panting, puffing, "Give me the cat, Yiddish shit." By the front door, I bumped into Storm. He moved me aside, stepped forward, gripped Nikita by his collar, and lifted him off the ground like a puppy. "Don't come here. Don't touch this girl. Don't touch this cat," he said. "You understand?" "I understand," said Nikita. I saw his pants getting dark around his crotch and pee streaming down his legs. Storm unclasped his hand, and the boy ran as if he had wheels. The cat scratched its way out of the bag, flipped in the air like a squirrel, landed on the grass, and disappeared into the basement. I looked at the long thin scratches on my arm. Storm looked at them too, nodded, and smiled. Ever since then, we formed something like a friendship. He sat still and smoked, as always, the black cat by his leg. I stood there staring at the cat and Storm's wrinkles and his scar. After 2 weeks, he asked me, "You want to know about the scar?" "No," I said. "Sit," ordered Storm. "I'll tell you a story. A long time ago, on a dark night, I came to Odessa from Amur on a long green train." "Amur means love in French," I said. "Amur was a small gangster town in Ukraine," said Storm. "Odessa was a mess. Ukrainians were killing Ukrainians, Russians were killing Russians, and everyone was killing us Jews. Bash East, they said, save Russia. I came with Jewish hitmen and crooks. We hit back. The Reds wore black leather jackets, boots that crinkled at night, and revolvers on straps. They won the war. The Whites fled on big ships to Istanbul." "The Whites were bad," I said. "The Whites were weak," said Storm. "Their time was up. Everyone has their time. Once your time is up, you go." "Were you a Red?" I asked. "I was a mobster. The mobsters took no sides. The mob had its own law. We lived in ruins, but we had pride. We wore bow ties. We her. If she said something, that's the way it was. She jumped like a cat off the roofs during robberies. She cut off diamond rings with fingers and carved hands on her lover's shoulders with her black switchblade. She carried it hidden inside of her boot. I could see Mook in my mind. She crawled on the roof of our building like a panther. I lost my mind over Mook a set storm. She smelled like a death in summer. Sweet sea and raw meat. Her hair looked like a black cat, like the Black Sea itself. Her eyes shone like ripe cherries, rotten cherries. When she sat near to me, I had no air to breathe. I rocked for her, I killed for her, I brought her money, cocaine, golden rings, bracelets, silks, lace, necklaces. In my mind, stone look a Mohican, a feathered head wrap, and a dagger. I called her Mooka, my little kitten. Mooka loved me too. She cut an M on my arm, under the linden, on the grass. Touch, close up, the scar was the color of overripe grapes. I reached my finger and patted the scar. It felt rough at the edges and smooth, velvety, like the cat's back on the needle. Did it hurt, I asked. It hurt. It hurt and bled good. Then Mooka did something she never had done. She got S on her arm for storm. Then she threw her switchblade at me and it flew and got stuck in the back of the linden. She laughed, her teeth white like sugar cubes. Don't close his eyes. His face looked like an ancient map, but his lips still moved. That summer life was good. Love was good. The mob ruled Odessa. Gunfire shook the streets. Then summer ended and in 4 months our time was up. Arrests, failures, raids fell like rain. Someone ratted us out. We couldn't find out who. Mooka got sad. She started to disappear. I tried to follow her, but she could vanish in the dark like a cat. Life was empty without Mooka. I started to drink. One night I went out with Moisha Tickle to take care of business, a corner drugstore robbery. Tickle wanted a drink. We went inside that kosher restaurant and I saw Mooka, her black hair. Then I saw a black leather jacket, a revolver on a strap on her hip. She laughed and the rat put his arm around her. That's how I knew who ratted us out. Who? I whispered. Mooka did. She ratted us out. I came to her and my heart bled. Mooka, I said. She didn't look at me, just kept laughing. Why? You had everything. Rings, skirts, jackets, love. What was that you wanted? I didn't say that. Instead, I said, hello, my dear Mooka. My dear, dear Mooka. Hello, my dear Mooka, and goodbye. And then I put her switchblade out of my boot and stabbed her in the back. And the rat jumped up, but I stabbed him too. And he fell down like a sack of potatoes next to her. Forgive me, Mooka, I said. I cleaned her blood on her stocking, the stocking I gave her. And I put the switchblade back into my boot and walked out. Did the rat catch you, I asked. Tears were running down my cheeks and I licked them with my tongue. I didn't want Storm to see I was crying. I knew Mooka was bad and Storm was bad. And I loved them even more because they were bad. No, said Storm. The old owner turned away. The other Jews in the restaurant just kept drinking. Jews didn't care for the rats. So I went out, and that was that. I loved her. We had our time, Mooka and I. You're a child. You don't understand, said Storm.